generally, we have to support that. And that's what, that's his desire. So, if we use third finger to link that, there is no break in the phrase, okay? And this is an exercise I like to use for my students to really show how to use third finger, where you feel fourth finger in the frame, extend slightly, make sure it's the same pitch, extend slightly four again, now you're in a new frame. Obvious practical use of that would be the monotone. So again, we could either do which people play very beautifully, and there's not necessarily anything wrong with that. You could also play, which many people do also, and do it very skillfully. But in Levinson's mind, there's still that slight disconnect. If you do not want to hear a slide, you really Beethoven 7 or anything like that. And if we did the same fingering, And also you have several string crossings in between the short note and the next note.
Yes.
Right? So it's not preferable. But if we did something like this, so much of this is hearing what you want, what really thinking, and he does this all the time. Any of you guys have studied with him or had any experience with him? I know Gary has. You'll get a fingering from him, and the very next week you go in, where did you get this finger? You gave it to me. No, I didn't. Same thing the next week. So, but it's because he it's because he recognizes that your hearing changes, right? You may not hear a phrase a certain way you did last week as you do this week, or 5 years from now as you're going to do now. And because of that, your fingering will change, because the fingering has to reflect the phrasing. Okay? So that's an example. If we go to E major, which is the next scale that he uses that because that's the start of the extension. So if we did, we have three notes that just repeat in different octaves. So what he's done, not always in the inversions, it's a series of seven arpeggios, minor, major, inversions, diminished, dominant, based on carpal flesh, just carpal flesh. The most important thing is the conception of the fingering. So you have three notes, large interval, shift on the large interval. Another three notes in the same position, etc. Okay. So if you look at E minor, you can see, if we just thought about E minor and kind of did what a lot of people would just automatically do, we'd do something like this. Right? The problem with that is that it could be okay, depending on the context, but one shift, two shifts consecutive, and the penultimate note and the ultimate note are not connected. Depends on what you want. You could have a very slow, but again, in a somewhat reductionist point of view, what will just work standard for agility? This is what he's done. If I wanted to do F minor, I would do this.
I didn't want to blow this up.
Yeah, I didn't do it very well, but
that's all right.
No,
it's,
you guys can always buy the book.
I
don't get paid for saying it. It's stressful. Okay.
I'll buy the book.
So you can see how that works. If I did E, let's go back to E. If I did E major, same thing.
Thank you.